I live on the main street, so I live on the main thoroughfare. I can tell the time of day by the traffic, by how much build-up there is. So I know when I wake up in the morning, whether it's 5 a.m., 6 a.m., 7 a.m., because I can tell by the traffic that's passing my door. It's very frustrating. I just feel like, you know, this is never ending. There's no getting out of this. There's no getting away from it. One of the measures that we took in our own house was to install actually two layers of windows. The outside window was double glazed and the inside window was triple glazed. So I've got five layers of glass between me and the noise outside. But also I became involved with Tidy Towns, and a lot of that now is based around sustainability and biodiversity and how we can help, you know, to improve those, the sustainability and biodiversity in our own communities at the grassroots level. Initiatives like the litter picking, it brings in everybody. It's easy to do, doesn't take very long. Children can take part. It's fantastic. I feel great about it. It's one of my favourite things in the world to do. And you have the best of people. The best people in the world will volunteer with Tidy Towns. Wonderful people. It's all about, you know, act local, think global. So what we do at this grassroots level, that's really what's making the difference. Like if everybody in the world did what we're doing here, you'd have a very big cumulative effect. We tried to run a poetry event on a Saturday morning, but it was a complete disaster because we hadn't mitigated for the noise. We hadn't mitigated for the noise of the traffic. The poor poet was shouting at the top of his voice, couldn't fight over the noise of the traffic. So it was an absolute disaster. It was meant to be for people who were coming to visit the farmers market, that they could listen to a little bit of poetry at the same time. And it just, and that was the reason for having it there, but the whole thing just fell asunder. We couldn't continue with it. It almost felt like just complete having to give in, and we were giving in to traffic. During COVID was a wonderful time in the village. There was very little traffic. We were able to sit out the front of our house and speak to our neighbour. We were all sat along, having a glass of wine, enjoying the street, and it was just unbelievable. It was something that I thought I would never witness in my lifetime. To be able to, you know, listen to the birds and to hear what was going on around, it was fantastic. We would comment on how wonderful it was to be able to sit outside and not listen, not have to listen to the constant noise of traffic. This has built up over the last, I'd say probably 25 years, this has built up. We, as people who live in the village, haven't really noticed that increase. It was only when we got an actual traffic count done, where they, you know, the council actually measured the level of traffic that was going through, that we realised the level that we were at. They were doing that to measure the village for the need for a bypass. So we absolutely and utterly blew the figures out of the water. Those figures became a trigger for me to actually make sure that, first of all, the bypass was in motion. But I was also pointing out, well, it's not just about the number, it's about the effect that the noise is having on our community. If I had one wish for my community and one wish for the future community that's going to live here in Adair, is that they could enjoy this village without having to listen to the large traffic volumes. And policy needs to support that, and the EU policymakers need to help in supporting that. Things like changing the logistical companies, helping them change to transition to electric vehicles, I think that will be one major help. We as a village want to help in the transitioning to carbon neutral by 2050. We are doing our part at local level. We're begging the policymakers to help us do that.